In this video, let's use Visual Studio Code to write a couple different enum definitions. I'll start by creating a new project called enums over in my terminal now. Once at my terminal in the Rust projects directory, I'm going to type cargo new enums. And then once that enums package is created, I will change directories to enums and open that up in Visual Studio Code. Once I'm in Visual Studio Code, I'll focus my attention on the main.rs program. And above the main function, I'll start by defining an enum to classify a web event. This enum will be called web event and have multiple different variants. First, there's going to be page load and page unload. Notice that these variants have no data associated with them at all. These are unit-like. Next, I will have a key press variant, which takes in a single character. This is like a tuple struct. Next up, I'll have paste, which will allow a string value. And then finally, I'll have a click variant, which will include an anonymous struct, including the types x, i64, and y, i64. In this example, you can get a better picture for how flexible enums truly are with being able to group lots of different types of data together. When I want to use or access a variant from the web event enum, I can do the following. Inside of the main function, I'll get rid of the println line and go ahead and define a new variable that I'll call quit. And then I will call the web event with the key press variant. And for the character, I want to pass in Q to indicate that that will quit the program. That's a simple way of how I can define one variable to access a variant. A similar convention can be followed when setting the value of other variants to variables. Another type of enum to explore is the option enum. This enum is defined by the standard library. The option type is used in many places because it captures the scenarios in which a value can either be something or nothing. Rust doesn't have null values, but it does have an enum to encode the concept of a value being either null or not null. The option enum is defined by the standard library as follows. I use the enum keyword and specify the name of the enum, which is option, with a parameter of t, which is a generic trait, which we'll talk about later. Then for the variant of this enum, I will have sum, which takes a type t, and then I will have none as the second variant there. What's interesting about the option enum is that it's included in the prelude, and it's not necessary to bring it into scope explicitly. So the variants sum and none can be used directly without the option prefix. Again, the T syntax that you see here and in the sum variant is a generic type parameter. What's important to know is that T means that it can hold some value that's one piece of data of any type. Let's explore how to use the option enum now. I can do the following if I want to access the sum variant of the enum option. I can define a variable called something is equal to someone. So this is how I can go ahead and use the sum variant of the option enum and just pass in some value, which here is type i32. Using the option enum is helpful to prevent common issues and handling that scenario before encountering an error. Not having to worry about incorrectly assuming a not null value helps you to be more confident in your code. There you saw a couple examples of enums in action. Enums are commonly used in programs, so it's important to get familiar with understanding how to implement and use them.